So if you want to replace the turn signal on a 2018 Chevy 2500 HD with the Duramax engine, you'll have less room in the engine, which is why it matters what engine you have. The first thing you need to do, just like any headlight, is you need to remove the air filter cover here, the filter itself, and then there's a casing that goes underneath it right here, and this just kind of pops out. You got to finagle with it a little bit, but it should come out of there. And then if you have a pry tool, similar to one kind of like this, be able to pull little grommets out. There's a plastic shield in the back side over here that you'll want to fold back. And if you have to change a headlight, a high or a low beam, there's covers right back here that you can access from there as well. But we are trying to change a top turn signal. Sometimes they recommend to go in from the wheel well, but the top one you cannot reach unless you have tiny arms. So you're actually going to come in through the hole in the side panel of the door where the air filter comes through, and you should be able to reach up to the front. Might have to do it with my other arm here. And what we're trying to get to, if you'll bring the camera right down in here, the bulb is the little deal right there that has the blue and yellow wire going to it. So that's what we're going to pull out. So I'll do that real quick and then I'll show you it. So here I'm getting the bulb out, and the turn signal bulb will look just like this. As far as a number on it, this is a Toshiba 12 volt 21-5W E2217. On here, nothing huge. We'll take that old one out. Be careful with these bulbs. You don't really want to touch them with your bare hands. The oil on your hands can make the life of them much shorter. If you'll bring the camera over here. So we actually have another headlight that I just wanted to show to you. So this is the backside of an actual headlight to 2015 Chevy. It was cracked, so we replaced it. The 2015 and 2018 headlight will be the same. Actually, 2015 through 2019 will all be the same for the 3/4 ton and the 1 ton trucks. So you can see right here, this is all the connections for the two turn signal bulbs that are appeared out here on the yellow. And then you have, I believe, low beam and high beam down here. So this is just all your connectors. If you wanted to replace all these with LEDs or something, you'd probably have to replace this harness. But in here, these things will need to be twisted. And they only twist about 1/8 of the way, and they pull right out, and then that's the bulb. So we're going to steal this bulb because I know the bulb works, and place it into this vehicle. And so this gets kind of tricky because you got to be able to hold the connector to get to it, and you don't have a ton of slack. So bear with me. This is our bad bulb. Here. That's our good one. Just need to find my wire again and see if I can pull it out a little more where I can work on it. Or if I can pull it through somewhere. Not really. This will be fun. So what I ended up doing is back here on the back side of the battery or the light, I actually disconnected the main power. I was just looking on my other bulb that I had off. And what you want to do is take the connector that is actually into the headlight, similar to over here. Look at this real quick. This piece right here, I unconnected it from its mounting spot on the light right there. And the reason I did that is because that gives me a lot more freedom to take this, and I can pull this further out to stick my new bulb in. So that's what I did in there. And so I'm still coming in through the vent hole on the side of the truck. And I've got the cord pulled out a lot further, enough that I can take the bulb with my other hand and hopefully, maybe, I don't know, get it in there. Quite tight. Okay, if you see that right there, I just barely got it far enough out that you can see the connecting point there. So now the light is in there. So then, now I want to try and turn it around without letting that bulb scratch anything against the side of the pickup. And I'm looking through this little spot right here. Wish I could get you a better camera angle, but that's where I'm looking. So there's not a lot of room to look. So I guess you can look in there real quick. And I'm trying to go into the hole right over there to the side. Not much room. Okay, now I've got it in. And I'm going to take this screwdriver and it's going to help assist me in turning it back. Maybe if I got to get it in there straight first. Turning it back so it locks into place. You gotta be very gentle, you don't want to break it. I think we're in. Gotta double check over here and make sure that's about what it looked like. So this side will stick out a little bit further. It looks like it's in there crooked on the current pickup, but in here you can see that that bulb isn't sitting flush with the plastic. It's actually tilted just a little bit, but it is locked in. So before we put it all back together, we're just going to check and make sure that bulb worked, and that it looks like it's shining correctly on the outside. So neither one works, but that's because I forgot to plug it back in. So you have to plug it back in before anything will work. And hopefully we can do this. It should not shock you. And now, both high and low come on. Originally this one was off, but now it looks like it's about the right size, but right place. Very similar to the other side that was just fine. So we're gonna call this good. I will turn the lights off and we will finish shooting, putting it all back together. Since I have all this torn apart, we just replaced this bulb in the video. A lot of these bulbs can be changed from that same process, but if you need to change this fog light down here, the easiest way to do that is to pull out the wheel well, the carpet that they put inside these just for sound dampening, and you're going to come behind the bumper, and it's actually pretty easy access right back in there. And if you look, you'll just pop that pin right there, pull that, or you disconnect the wire, and then you'll twist the bulb out, and then you can replace that. So that one's not terribly hard to replace, other than getting all this put back together. So I took this off in the process to get that side turn signal out. You don't necessarily need to, but it gives you a little more visibility when you're working in there. What this is a waterproof cover that goes on top of your low beam lights. And it actually goes back inside this hole. It'll have a little bit of writing on there, and it'll tell you which way's up. This has a 1 on it, and so that will face up as we go in, and then it'll get a little twist. You wanna make sure that that one is square with the plastic, and then it just gets a little 1/8 of a turn as well. Now, next step is we have connected this wire harness here, and there's a little metal bracket that connects to the light, and it just pushes back in there. That just keeps it from rattling. And as you saw, we took this shield off. Now the next step is to put that back on, and all you got to do is feel that back up, and then it's got 4 little pins that, if you're lucky, you did not destroy in the process of pulling them apart. If you did destroy them, they're not terribly expensive, but they do help keep dust from getting into places. They should push back in if you're strong. I'm not strong. That one's in there. If you just wiggle them, they'll go in better than if you try and use your muscle, actually. Some of them. Everything's a hammer. that's back on. And now, next step, because this is a Duramax with the diesel engine and glow plugs, it will have a connector here to plug in. You want to make sure you don't bury that underneath your air filter when you reinstall it. Otherwise, you may never find it. So we're just going to put that out of the way. And then we're going to bring this cover back in. So how this sits in there is similar to this down in there. You want this foam ring to be placed up against that hole we were reaching in to get that turn signal light out. And should fit right down in there pretty easily. I'll make sure I didn't break it. So it works better if you tip down and then come back in. There's a couple little pins that you'll kind of feel it drop into once you get it where it's supposed to be. We're getting close. Shouldn't move that much. Okay, so now that we've got this set, it doesn't necessarily fit perfectly in there. It's just one of those things that stays pressed to the wall on that foam ring when you apply everything back to it, which is kind of the important part. So now that we've got that pretty well sucked up in against here, and the other thing to look for is when you're looking at this ring here, this comes from the hood scoop on the 2017, 18, and 19 models. You just want it to be pushed up against. It comes from the hood back into here. That's just an airflow thing for this model. So next you will place in your air filter, and then from there this will come back around and these three slots will slide into the three slots down below after your air filter is placed in here, and you'll take either a flat screwdriver or I believe it's a 5/16 socket and tighten those two back up onto there, and you are set to go. One other thing to note for this specific one, we ended up taking the cover off of the front side along the grill to the radiator, it's shown over there. We took that off mostly because we didn't know what we were doing, and also gave us a little more visibility because it actually covers up this space, and by taking it off we were able to look down in there, and that sure helped. So hope this helps. The reason we made this video is there's lots of videos out there on how to change a headlight, but nothing on how to change the turn signals, and it was kind of a pain in the butt to figure out. So, good luck.